So for CSS, we made our page look nicer, but it's kind of annoying to have to update the date every day with this app. So we could use JavaScript to get that info from the browser and do it automatically. So Intro to JS is a remix of Intro to CSS. It starts with a very short introduction to JavaScript. It has all the HTML and CSS files from our previous remixes, but we've added app.js, which includes all of our JavaScript to get the current date from the browser, format it to look normal to humans, and instead of saying today on index.html, we'll have it show the date automatically, so you don't have to go to it every day.
JavaScript is a language that's used in combination with HTML and CSS on web pages to add behavior to those web pages. JavaScript usually listens to something called an event, which might be a page load or a click to do something. So once you have that event, you're going to define a function, which is just a chunk of code that's going to do something when that event happens. For example, if you want to have an alert window that pops up on your page loads, you're going to have an onload event, and you're going to set up an alert text that might say something like hello to whoever's loaded your page. Something that you might want to use JavaScript for is to build something that's interactive to your users when you are building a web page. For example, I once had to build a tic-tac-toe app. And I wanted it to mark an X or an O based on where a user clicked and which turn it was. So I could define pretty easily what that table is going to look like. It's just a 3x3 grid on the web page, and I can manipulate the colors using CSS and make it look pretty, by styling it differently. But if I want to add a behavior, that's where I'm going to want to use JavaScript.
So let's show the app. And it has the current date. Today just happens to be January 11th, and my status, which I've hard-coded every day. And app.js is loaded into our HTML file, our index.html file, using the script tag here. You can either do your JavaScript within the script tags, or you can import it from an external file. And in this app, we have an external file, app.js, and our HTML knows to load that. And then it will then look for our ID date element here, and replace today with whatever the date is when the user is going to the page. In this video, we learned about JavaScript and how we can use it to add cool behaviors and functions to our site. And then we remixed our app in order to add JavaScript to get the date from the browser. You can go to that app and view the source by going to intro-to-js.glitch.me. And in the next video, we're going to continue using JavaScript, but on the server side with a framework called Node.